Douglas, could you give me the broad strokes of the Sawney Bean legend?
Well, Sawney Bean, according to the story, was born in the Lothians. He was a son of a ditcher and a hedger who wanted his son to follow the family trade. But Sawney had different ideas. He would rather cut throats than cut hedges. And he took up with a lady of ill repute and moved to the west coast of Scotland, here to Cannock, as the favourite is. But parts of the story say that it was further down the coast at the Mull of Galloway. Mm-hmm. And they made their home in a cave, and there they set about raising a family, a very large extended family. They subsisted by robbing unwary travellers on the road and dragging them back to the cave and eating them. Now, this went on for about 25 to 30 years. They say about 1,000 people disappeared over that time, and body parts would wash up on the various beaches as the beans just threw the waste into the sea here. A man and a woman were returning from a country fair and were waylaid by the Bean clan, as they were known later. He managed to get away, and he told his story in Glasgow, bypassing air for some reason, told his story in Glasgow. The King of Edinburgh was alerted. He came here to the west coast of Scotland with a small army of about 4,500 men and dogs, and they combed the countryside. The dogs eventually sniffed out the sea cave that the Beans were living in. It was kind of protected because at high tide the entrance would be flooded. The men went in and they found this chamber of horrors, essentially, which was the Beans in the shadows snarling and howling at them, and the body parts hanging from the ceiling and in barrels pickled and on tables, etc. The Beans were then carted back to Edinburgh. They didn't even get a trial. They were summarily executed rather brutally. And the legend began.
So this does fit the legend, right? Vast chamber.
Yeah.
It's down on the Garvan Shore somewhere.
Yeah.
But you reckon this is possibly not the Sawney Bean Cave?
No, this is not the Sawney Bean Cave. The Bean Cave, as it were, went deep underground. So they probably could make it quite habitable for themselves. And they would have fires going. Hopefully there was some way for the smoke to get out. But they'd probably have some way of keeping themselves heated. They didn't have gas central heating, obviously.
So considering everything you know about the Sawney Bean legend, what is the seed of truth in that legend?
Well, they say that there was a real-life cannibal murderer, but it was up in the Highlands. His name was Christy Cleek. Sawney Bean himself didn't really appear until the early 1700s, and that was in the broadsheets and the chapbooks of the London press at the time. Now, that leads to the theory that it was an invention to denigrate the Scots and to demonise the Scots, which they were trying to do at the time. Sawney was a derogatory term in the press for the Scot, like a cartoonish version of the Scot. And this story was then told and retold in order to say, look at these people north of the border, they're barbaric. This horror was going on under their noses for 25 years and they couldn't do anything about it. It became entrenched, not just in the mythology of Scotland, but in the psyche of Scotland. So Sawney and his family are really all part of us in a way, and it's a story to frighten children. It's a story that's told, it's a ghost story. We like our ghost stories in Scotland, as Robert Louis Stevenson called them, a fine wee fearty. And this is the primary fine wee fearty in Scottish folklore.